guidance. Hope your 2021 is going well, and we are back from the new year.
We have a great episode coming up. I hope you enjoy.
Guys, welcome. I am Philip Olivier and Andy HS Senior, and I am here to tell you guys about my sport, which is swim. Now, the things I'm going to be telling you guys about are my weekly schedule, the equipment that I use during practice, and also the COVID protocol that my club REA follow. Now, let's start with my weekly schedule. Monday through Friday, I practice from 3:30 to 5:30 p.m. And also on Saturday, I practice from 8 to 10 a.m. Okay, let's continue with the equipment that I use during practice. Now, first things first. Obviously, we need a Speedo so we can get in the pool. For swim meets, I wear this thing called a tech suit, which makes me a little faster so I can shave a little seconds off of my time. Now, after practice, I need this, which is a towel to dry myself off before I can change back into my regular clothes. This is called a swim bag or an swim equipment bag, which is used to contain the pieces of equipment that I use during practice day to day, which let's see what's in it. So first a cap, but I use a cap during swim meets only because during swim practice, I need to drag in order to maximize my training. Aha! Swim goggles. I need swim goggles in order to actually see what's underwater, and so I can see the black line, so I know when to flip turn and when to not. My earplugs. I use earplugs to keep the water out of my ears, like so. And these earplugs reduce the risk of water getting in your ears so that it can help prevent stuff like ear infections. And we all know that if you have an ear infection, you're basically kicked out of the pool depending on how bad the infection is. Let's continue on to my pool buoy, which I put in right here. And also, there I have swim paddles, which are used with the pool buoy for sets like pool sets, which pool sets are exercises to correct your stroke without kicking. And yeah, they correct your stroke, and also they make it a little stronger because of the resistance that these paddles put. Okay, let's continue on with the fins, which fins are used to survive fast-paced sets, which obviously sets are so fast that they require fins. And also, a kickboard. Kickboards are used during kick sets, which I like to put, for this board, I like to put my hands through these and kick like so, like this. And last but not least, for equipment, I have my water bottle, which is used to drink water when I'm thirsty and the coach hits me with a hard set like 100s on a 110. Let's continue with the COVID protocol that my club follows. So obviously, in this COVID-19 pandemic, you need a mask. Without a mask, the coaches will not let you in the pool deck.
Okay guys, I'm gonna show you how we migrate in and out of the pool. And remember guys, mask is important. Oh, Coach Rodney, you're our sub.
I am.
Here back with this episode's edition of the Sports Update.
In college football news, Alabama won the college football national championship over Ohio State 52-24, led by Mac Jones passing for 464 yards and 5 touchdowns, Najee Harris scoring 3 touchdowns, and Devonta Smith hauling in 12 receptions for 215 yards and 3 touchdowns in just the first half. In NFL news, there were some pretty interesting matchups this past weekend in the divisional championship rounds. The Ravens' offense was stifled by the Bills' defense in a 17-3 loss. Drew Brees played in his last NFL game in a loss to the Bucks 30-20. Patrick Mahomes got hit late in the third quarter and is now in concussion protocol, and the Browns were robbed by a no-call on a targeting penalty that could have won them the game. They ended up losing to the Chiefs 22-17. And the Rams lost. Lol Rams. With this, the Packers, Bills, Chiefs, and Bucks have advanced to the conference championship round. My Super Bowl prediction for this season is the Packers win over the Bills 24-17. In MLB news, some big free agents are starting to sign, and there have been some huge trades that could possibly change the landscape of the MLB. DJ LeMahieu, one of the biggest free agents this offseason, has decided to re-sign with the Yankees for 6 years, $90 million. Liam Hendricks, one of the big-name relievers in this offseason's free agent class, signed to the White Sox for 3 years, $54 million. Blake Treinen, a huge piece of the Dodgers' World Series run, just re-signed with the Dodgers for 2 years, $17.5 million. And Corey Kluber decided to sign with the Yankees for 1 year, $11 million. We are still waiting on big-name free agents such as Trevor Bauer, Nelson Cruz, George Springer, JT Realmuto, Michael Brantley, Marcelo Ozuna, Marcus Semien, and others to sign with the team. The Cleveland baseball team recently traded Francisco Lindor and Carlos Carrasco to the Mets. Star pitcher Blake Snell was traded from the Rays to the Padres, and the Padres also acquired ace Yu Darvish from the Cubs. And now for NBA news. The NBA is having trouble with COVID cases, so some teams haven't played as much as others. But as of now, the Lakers sitting at 11-3 and the Clippers sitting at 10-4 have the best records in the league. A huge trade between the Nets and the Rockets was made this past week, sending James Harden to the Nets. The Nets now have a big three of James Harden, Kevin Durant, and Kyrie Irving whenever he decides he wants to play basketball. That's it for this episode's edition of the Sports Uptake. See you next time, Titans.
A Saturday morning with Toria. My alarm goes off at 6:40 a.m. I get up, brush my teeth, and get dressed for practice. Grab my bag, fill up my water, and head out the door. I get there, I put on my mask and head in. We get our gear on and stretch before coach shows up. Practice ends anywhere between 10 to 12. On my way home, I fill up my gas tank, then I head over to my brother's football game. And that concludes my Saturday mornings. Hey guys, so today for my new food in the new year, I'm going to be trying a dragon fruit.
which I've never tried before, obviously. So I've been told that a dragon fruit can taste kind of like a kiwi, just not as sweet. So I just peeled it back. I'm gonna try it. It really just tastes like nothing. It doesn't even taste like anything, but I think the seeds and how soft the texture is, it's like weird. Kind of makes me uncomfortable. I would give this like a 6, 5 out of 10. I don't know. It doesn't really taste like anything, but yeah. And that is my new food in the new year.
Hey guys, it's a new year and that means we're gonna try new food. So I picked up these dill pickled flavored potato chips. I've already opened the bag. I'm kind of nervous because they kind of smell funky, but I like pickles, but I don't know how they're gonna taste on a chip. So. I mean, they kind of taste like pickles, but like very, very sour. It's kind of gross. Today I'm gonna try the cheddar jalapeno ones. They kind of smell a little funky, but let's see. They taste good. Interesting flavor. So for my third and final chip, I'm gonna be trying Flaming Hot Dill Pickle flavors. As you can tell, I really like pickles. I'm not really a big fan of pickled flavored chips. I thought it'd be interesting and something exciting to see. So excited. I mean, it's still okay. I did not like that.
Hey guys, it is me, Wyatt Rodarte, and I'm here to give you all a movie review. So back in September and October, two people voted for Lego Clutch Powers, and they won. But we couldn't watch it back then because we didn't have the accessibility to it. But this time, we are able to do it. So, the whole premise of the movie is just Clutch Powers and his team must go fight an evil wizard named Malik to protect a medieval-style world named Ashlar. So the actors in this is Ryan McParlin as Clutch Powers, Jeff Bennett as Bernie Von Beam, Roger Rose as Brick Masterton, and Yvonne Strahovski as Peg Mooring. So let me just get it out of the way. This movie is a clear 10 out of 10. Even if like, it just hit me with a lot of nostalgia from my past, because constantly throughout the whole movie, I was remembering like the good times, such as like Wow Wow Wubsy. Remember that show? That was a good show. No idea if they still air it, I hope. But also like this Nintendo DS game called like Zuzu Pets, which I didn't understand how to play. All I did was just kind of travel across the map to take baby hamsters, and that was kind of it. But like the movie was just really nice. It was comedic at times, a little bit weird, but I think we all need a little bit of weirdness. Peace.
Hi.
Hi, I'm here today with Leanne, Isabel, Luke, and Steven, and today we are going to be doing a Titan TV spelling bee. Our team with Isabel and Luke is called Olivia, and then Leanne and Steven's group is called Sabrina. Okay, let's get started. So first we're going to have Leanne and Isabel play rock, paper, scissors, and the winner of that gets to try spelling the word first. Leanne won that one. Leanne, we're going to start you off with an easy word. Can you spell tourniquet? I can use it in a sentence for you.
Was that an easy word?
Come on, you're the SEA reigning non-champion runner-up. A tourniquet.
Tourniquet. T.
E. A for effort.
Is it E?
Okay. Try spelling it.
You look at E.
Yeah. Okay, E. Isabel, do you want to try?
Try.
Come on. You got this.
Okay, tourniquet. Can I phone a friend?
No. Okay, we're gonna change the word now. Steve it up.
Oh my god.
It's actually spelled.
Is it Y? Is it Y?
No, it's T O U R N I Q U E T.
Bro, that's wrong. I would say that if you let me finish.
Okay. But I can't see your hand.
Dang it. I didn't
want to
go.
There you go. Here. No, you got this.
Mitochondria. Would you like to know the definition? I know this one.
No, I got this.
Powerhouse of the cell. Okay.
mitochondria.
Woo, y'all got your first point. Narcissistic. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Okay, come on, Lou. Try spelling narcissistic. Okay. Narcissistic. N-A-R. C. I. S. S. I. S. T. I see.
Hey, you got it. You got it.
That was clean. That was clean.
Y'all are now losing by 2 points. You guys can come back. Okay.
What if
I just give them the next one to try out first?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, you're going to
make it. Dang. Like, wow.
Okay. Vengeance.
Come on, Steven.
E-N-G. E-N-C-E?
No, Luke, would you like to try?
Okay. Vengeance. V-E-N-G-A-N-C-E. Vengeance.
No, Mia, do you want to try?
V-E-N-G-E-A-N-C-E.
Woo, they got their first point! Woo-hoo!
Yeah!
I don't know about that.
Okay. Questionnaire.
Question.
Okay.
Oh, you got this.
Q-U-E-S-T-I-O-N. A-I-R-E.
Wrong. Steven,
what?
Would you like to try? This is the final point.
Okay. Question.
What?
Read it. I mean, not read it. Say it in your head.
Luke, you got it.
U-E-S-T-I-O-N-E-R.
No, I'm sorry. Luke, would you like to try? No cheating. No.
Okay. Question.
Q-U-E-S-T-I-O-N-A-R-E.
Question.
Wrong.
A-R-E.
Leanne, would you like to go?
Sure. I mean, I have to. Sure. Questionnaire. Q. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Yeah.
Okay. Q U E S T I O N N A I R E.
So you got it.
No.
It's two N's.
My God.
No.
So the winners are Sabrina, Team Sabrina. Your prize is the reigning champions of Notre Dame, or just Titan TV spelling bee.
Woo! Yeah!
Cheers! Get bragging rights.
Woo! Cheaters! Who said that? Cheaters!
simple questionnaire.
I just don't know how to spell.
Old PH kids. I know these old PH.
Wow.
Kids,
okay, first of all, for the old PH spelling bee, I purposely got out because I did not want to participate.
Yeah. I tried, and Leanne would always beat me, and I never even made it to the.
It was always the smart kids that we let go.
We focused on the swag, not the.
Yeah. The smarts.
Luke, you were there too. What did you do?
We were smart. That's what we did.
He played basketball.
Hi, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Luke Stitch 431 here. I just want to say thank you to all my fans. Drop them in the comments below what we should do next. And yeah, let's keep it rolling.
Guys, the comments of this video will be turned off. There will be no shout-outs given. That'll all be censored.
For our next video idea, if we get this up to 200 likes, we will make a diss track on...
Oh. St. James.
On OLPH. OLPH will get a diss
track.
No. My handle?
St. Catherine and OLPH kids will make a diss track on St. Edward's kids.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you guys for checking out this week's episode. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you guys next time.